News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil.
What's our story?
Today we have a vaccination story.
Okay, a vaccination story. Let's find out some more from this BBC Radio 2 news bulletin.
Doctors in the United States say they're worried about the number of families in some communities who are choosing not to vaccinate their children. The World Health Organization has already warned that measles is spreading through parts of Europe because of falling immunization rates.
So, a story there that originates in the United States, where there are a growing number of families who choose not to take their children to the doctor for a vaccination. Now, a vaccination is a drug that will stop you from getting certain illnesses, such as measles or polio, for example. And last month, the World Health Organization warned that measles, the disease measles, is spreading through parts of Europe because of a similar phenomenon. People are not taking their children to the doctor for vaccination.
Okay, well, you've been looking at this story in the various news websites. What are the three words you've picked out that we need to understand to talk about this story?
Yep, so three words today are outbreak, sweeping and shun.
Outbreak, sweeping and shun. So your first headline with outbreak.
Okay, so we'll go to BBC News and we have measles outbreak across Europe.
So outbreak, sudden start and spread of a disease.
Yep, and it's an interesting use because the verb form of a sudden start and spread of something would often be to break out.
Mm.
Two words, measles broke out or has broken out in Europe. Now, you can put those words together to make a noun, break out,
yep.
But often to describe a disease, you reverse the two words and you call it an outbreak. It's a noun form, one word, outbreak.
OK, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Because, as you said, breakout is also used to mean the same thing, but less frequently.
I think so, yes. And an outbreak is a sudden start and spread of a disease. You can use it with other things. It's a very common way to use this word. You can have an outbreak of usually something bad,
yeah.
An outbreak of war, an outbreak of fighting.
Famine,
yes. Plague, disease, things that start and spread in a bad way, bad things that start and spread, we call them outbreaks.
Yeah. I have heard it used in a slightly, I guess, ironic way.
And I think you can talk about, interestingly, the phrase that we use is an outbreak of something.
Mm.
Now, it's very common to talk about an outbreak of fighting or an outbreak of war.
Bad stuff.
But we can also talk about an outbreak of peace or an outbreak of goodwill or good feeling. And this probably wasn't originally quite an ironic use of the mm-hmm. term outbreak. But we've got kind of used to it now, although there's a bit of a surprise at the end because you're expecting an outbreak of something bad,
yeah.
But you actually get an outbreak of something good, like peace.
Yeah, like that meeting we had the other day, quite angry meeting.
It was a bit sort of aggy, wasn't it? You know, people weren't very happy with something that had been happening recently. It was a bit tense.
Yeah, then the boss turned up.
Yeah.
With a big tray of donuts.
A big tray of donuts. So we all stuffed our faces with cake and donuts.
Yeah.
There was an outbreak of goodwill.
There was. So your next word then, please, next headline.
Let's have a look at the Sun. Is your kid safe? Highly contagious measles is sweeping through Europe, health experts warn.
So sweeping, meaning moving and spreading quickly.
Yes.
Now, I was moving and spreading something quickly across my kitchen floor the other day.
That would be...
like this.
With a great
sweeping.
Big brush.
Yes.
Yeah.
So what is this sweeping? What's this about?
Well, there's a similar meaning, as there often is with these words. So if you think about you sweeping your kitchen floor, all those crumbs and biscuits and broken crockery and whatever else you leave on your kitchen floor, Neil, moving it all in one direction, getting everything in a big way, lots and lots of movement, all going to one end of your kitchen floor. So it's that big movement of everything, a wide and full movement. And we use it idiomatically to describe the spread of this disease. If it's sweeping across Europe, it's moving rapidly and and widely.
Yeah.
Yeah. All over, everywhere.
And we can use it for many different things to describe, for example, the spread of a rumour.
Yes. The rumours spread through the office, yes. Or somebody's popularity can sweep mm-hmm. across the nation. Yeah. So feelings, emotions, and in this case, disease as well. Yeah.
OK, our next and final headline.
OK, and now we're looking at The Independent. Measles outbreak spreads across Europe as parents shun vaccinations, World Health Organization warns.
Shun, meaning avoid deliberately.
Yes, and this is a real newspaper word. It's used in newspapers to mean a lot of different things. Avoid, ignore, reject, turn down, as in reject an invitation. Yeah. But newspapers love this word, shun. It's kind of short, it's fairly dramatic. But it's important to realise this one, probably you don't use it so much in your everyday English. I don't shun your invitations, Neil. I just turn them down.
You just ignore me.
Yes.
And that's an interesting point, isn't it? A lot of the time you can see words like this in headlines, in newspapers, and they're handy for headline writers because they're short and dramatic. But actually, we don't use them when we're speaking that much. But it's important to be aware of them.
Absolutely, yes. And we can, and newspapers will use them in lots of different contexts. So a politician can shun an invitation to a meeting. You can talk about not going anywhere. Travel companies shun certain destinations. They won't go there because of danger mm-hmm. or the political instability. So this word shun means lots of different things, but it means avoid something because it's negative.
Yeah. Well, we're not going to shun our Facebook audience.
Good.
So we've been talking about vaccinations, and one way of receiving a vaccination is by injection. We asked, which of these is a slang word for an injection? Is it A, stab, B, poke, or C, jab? What kind of response did we have?
OK, so on Facebook, lots of response as usual. Interesting comment from Haroldo Tajira, who said, poke, that's where the name Pokemon comes from. And there are a couple of smiley faces, but just to get the picture right, Pokemon actually comes from Pocket Monster.
Yep.
So it's not quite
connected.
Right. Nope. But the correct answer from Fab Persian, Aresto Giulistani and Somvia Sharma said the correct answer is C, a jab is a slang term for an injection.
Excellent. Right then, a recap of our vocabulary, please.
Yes, we had outbreak, which is the sudden start and spread of a disease. Sweeping means moving and spreading quickly. Shun, avoid deliberately.
Well, if you would like to test yourself on today's vocabulary, there's a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other videos and materials to help you improve your English. Thanks for joining us and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.